Hi everyone, in this video I will be showing you how to create a use case diagram for ATM system. So I'm going to do this entire thing in staruml. So let's get started. So just go to staruml and go to model, and you will be having this add diagram. You have to select use case diagram, and you will be getting all the necessary tools to draw your use case diagram. And in this I will be using three actors. The first actor is going to be the customer who wants to go to the ATM and withdraw any amount, and the second actor is going to be the bank system. And the third one is going to be the technician who maintains and like repairs the ATM in case something goes wrong. So these are going to be the three actors. So first let me click on the actor shape, and I will just put it over here. So I will name it as customer. Yeah, and I'll just click it again, and it's going to be the bank system. So these are going to be the two primary actors. I will come to the technician at the end. So whenever the customer is going to an ATM, the first thing that the customer is going to do is like insert the credit card. So I would like you to imagine as if you are doing or going to an ATM, so that it will be easy for you to get more use cases. Just personify yourself as if you are doing that particular task. So first thing is going to be inserting your card and entering your password, and the bank system will validate and authenticate if it is correct or wrong. So first use case is going to be insert card and enter pin. Yeah, so let me just now, yeah, this is fine, I guess. Increase the size, and I will just drag and put it in the center. So this is going to be the first thing. All right, so customer is going to do this particular task. I will draw the arrow lines at the end. And the second one is going to, second use case is going to be authentication, or you can also have it as validation or something. It's your choice. I will go with authentication, and this is performed by the banking system. So this one is going to be like customer is going to insert the card, and the banking system is also going to like verify and do all those processing stuff. But this authentication is exclusive use case for the bank system, because the customer isn't going to do anything with authentication. It's totally to the banking system. All right, so what I mean by banking system is that the machine, the raw machine that you see right in an ATM, as well as the backend processing, like connected to the banking database. All right, the entire stuff, I mentioned it as banking system. It's not that just the machine. So authentication, and once you're done with authentication, next thing is going to be like checking the balance or withdraw the cash. So there are multiple options. So it's going to be, yeah, checking balance. I think this option is available in some kind of ATMs. Checking balance, you can still do that as well. And next one is going to be withdrawing cash. Yeah, so you can enter a cash, and if you have sufficient balance, you will get the money. And if you haven't having the sufficient cash, it will display an error message, you don't have enough balance. So it's going to be withdraw cash. Yeah, so this is fine now. So yeah, withdraw cash. Let me move it all to the top so that I will have some enough space at the end. So it's going to be withdraw cash. Yeah, and I think we can even transfer funds. You can add that. I will add that as well. I think this is also supported in very few ATMs. Transfer funds through ATM, I think this isn't available now, but in certain things, this you can even send money through an ATM. Like, I don't know, but you can still do that, I guess. And next one is going to be generate the receipt. That's it, I guess. This is what you do with an ATM system. Generate receipt. Yeah, and yeah, pretty much that's the thing. Yeah, if you want to add another one more thing, it's going to be like you can have here check select the account type. Select account type, because in some cases there's going to be the savings account and the current account, something like that. So in case if you are like having that, like if the customer has two types of accounts, so you can just like add that as well. Select account type, it's optional. So if you like too much, you can just remove this select account type and transfer funds. I think these are some like olden day ways of doing that. If you want to also have them, and if you have majority of like large number of use cases, you can still go with them. Okay, so this is going to be it for customer and bank system. And next one is going to be the maintenance and repair. So I will just have a actor first. Okay, actor. Yeah, so actor is going to be ATM tech. I think I've spelled it correctly. Yeah, this one is technician is going to have, yeah, repair and maintenance. All right, repair and maintenance of the ATM. So in case the ATM machine is not working and there is like insufficient cash, everything is done by this ATM technician. Like it includes everyone over there. So this is pretty much a diagram. Next I will just go with the association or arrow lines. So I will go with association and I will go with customer to this one. Yeah, insert a card and I will just drag it a bit. Yeah. And next one, the authentication is going to be purely performed by the bank system. This is also going to be the bank system. So this arrow lines is based upon what actors are involved in a particular task. All right. So even though the customer is going to insert the card, the bank system is also going to like involve in the card. Like it needs to scan that particular number from the card. So it's just based on involvement of a particular actor during a use case. So authentication, only the bank is involved in the authentication, not the customer. And select account type is going to be like common. Yeah, because bank is also involved, the user is also involved. And this is also going to be common. Yeah, and withdraw cash. Generate receipt is also going to be common. So many common things in this. And to be honest, it's always good to have some use cases like unique for each actor, to be honest. Like it should be like there should be unique use cases for customer, unique use cases for bank system, as well common for both. So it should be like a mix of everything. Yeah, generate receipt. And if you come down, ATM technician is going to have only this, and the customer isn't going to have the repair and maintenance, so don't do that. ATM technician alone. And at the end, add it to bank system. Bank system is involved in everything. You can't do anything without bank. Yeah. So this is, I think, pretty much it. And I hope you would have found this video useful. I've also done many other use case diagrams, activity diagrams, and UML diagrams. You can go and check the playlist of my channel. So I've also done programming tutorials in C, C++, Java, Python, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB, MySQL. So do check other videos of my channel. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.